Later, he turned the light back off. I turned the light back on, told him to get the fuck out. I was only 19 at the time. I said, man, I've been waiting my whole fucking life to see this shit. Lights are staying on. How the fuck y'all doing? I don't get a picture of you pretty people with my family fucking owl, man. My bass player's mad at me. Get your motherfucking hands up, baby! gosh, damn, there's a lot of motherfuckers in there. If you're testing positive for THC, make some fucking noise! My younger days, my grandmother, she once asked me, she said, boy, when you grow up, you gonna be a doctor, a lawyer? I said, no, ma'am. When I grow up, I'm gonna be Johnny Cash. Boy, that tickled my grandma something awful. She said, boy, you can't be Johnny Cash. Johnny Cash is Johnny Cash. You just gotta be yourself. And I said, well, then by God, I'm gonna be myself wearing all black all the time, just like Johnny fucking Cash. Later on in life, in my whiskey drinking years, when I was 9, I started telling all my whiskey drinking toddler buddies that before I came and went on this great planet, I will have drank more whiskey than Waylon Jennings. Then came the 10 years and I discovered this wonderful flower we like to call THC. I went to smoking that shit like a California forest fire, boy. I burned down! Started telling all my weed smoking buddies, before I come and go on God's great planet Earth, I will have smoked more weed than Willie Nelson. The moral of the story is you gotta be careful what you push out into the universe. The universe might just accept it as reality, and you might find yourself many years later somewhere in fucking Ohio standing in front of a bunch of crazy motherfuckers. Dressed in all black, just like the late, great Johnny Cash. I regret to inform you I've only drank about half as much whiskey as Waylon, but it does not go without trying. You see, I got a whiskey thieving drummer goes by the name of Hitman Timmy Brown. And I know old Willie got a many year on me, but when it comes to smoking that weed, y'all know, Willie know, everybody know, I'm right on Willie's fucking ass. So I learned quick. If someone asks you what you want to be when you grow up, be sure you give the right fucking answer. So whenever somebody would come up to me and say, what are you going to be when you grow up, son? I'd tell them, I'm going to be an outlaw, baby! Yeah. shit rolling.
Yeah.
And take you all the way back to the first album here. Do some old school shit for you. Call this one here, Back From coming out tonight, man. Come on. Y'all some badass motherfuckers. Surrounded by fucking badasses, young boy. Surrounded. I'd like to remind you that somewhere around here, I mean, I know a lot of bands like to call it a merchandise booth. Merchandise booth just sounds fucking filthy to me. We prefer to call ours a THC paraphernalia station. And what we want you to know is we know that you work hard for your fucking money. And when you know that we know that when you go to spend that shit on our fucking name to go out there and wear it like a fucking billboard, we want you to know that we appreciate the fuck out you motherfuckers. And another thing we want y'all to know is that the IRS will see none of that fucking money. That's a true fucking story. Speaking of true stories, call this one here Knee Deep. motherfuckers up here behind me, if you don't mind. Ladies and gentlemen, first and foremost, let me introduce you to the new guy. Been with us about a year now. Before he had joined this band, he had never been arrested and never been to jail. In the last year, he's been arrested and he's been to jail. Welcome to the Band of Outlaws. Y'all put your hands together for the drug dealer, Nevada Romo. Motherfucking one. Yeah. Cannot be thrown, will not be thrown. I call him the Bull Rider. Ladies call him the Porn Star. On bass guitar, Mr. John Ansonia. Y'all know anything about me, you know that nobody loves me except my mama, and she don't love me that fucking much. Only thing I like to do in the morning is get fucking laid. I do not like getting out of bed for shit. I ain't much of a people person. I've been known to spend my whole fucking day pissed off and mad the fuck about it. But when I'm out here on tour, I have the pleasure of waking up to this old boy here to the left of me. He's always got a smile on his face, which tends to put a smile on my face. You know what I'm talking about, baby? So it's my pleasure to introduce to you, loved by many, hated by none, Texas' favorite son, Cord Ketchup Pope! Thank you. Speaking of sorry, motherfuckers. This motherfucker thinks that a seal on a whiskey bottle is only an invitation to break a fucking seal on a whiskey bottle. A whiskey thief and son of a bitch. Nothing against his mother. Y'all make some noise for one of the baddest motherfuckers to ever sit on the throne, the hit man, Timmy Brown! Texas to Dayton, Ohio, just to turn it off!
Little Sarah was in Texas. She was a preacher's daughter. She never liked this much of those things her father taught her. One night at Penny's Clubhouse,
want y'all to know something. Y'all was singing y'all's fucking asses off on that. Sound like a motherfucking redneck choir. Badass motherfuckers. Oh yeah, let's just get, fuck this shit. I don't know what I'm saying. I like this one right here. Hey man, y'all be sure to follow John on Instagram and shit, because he talks to people. I don't ever post shit hardly ever. John, he's a good guy, man. He's good. My kids always like me like, man, I like John. I was like, what about your dad? Yeah, well. Yeah. I got John a present for his birthday. Can you give it to him for me? I was like, you didn't give me shit.
True story.
You didn't even give me nothing for Father's Day. You got John a fucking present? He's a good guy. Y'all make some noise for my boy John, will you? And for the rest of you folks out there, damn you to hell!
I'm taking the time to get you, 'cause I'm a god.
used to sell weed for a living. It was easy for me being from Texas. I just dropped down south of the border by 1,800 pounds. On the way back, 600 of them would go to either the Federales or the Rebels, whichever's turn it was. 600 get picked up by Border Patrol. 600 go to the house with me. I remember the time, and I need to take this up with John, because I remember the time I called John up and said, John, I need to drop a deep freeze off over at your house. John said, bring it on over. Had 600 pounds of weed in that deep freeze. Damnedest thing was, I come back 10 days later to get that deep freeze, only 598 pounds in there. Motherfuckers. Down south the border, they fucking took a liking to me for some reason. Some of them called me Mean Gringo, some of them called me Ricardo, which I thought was weird as fuck. But most of them referred to me as El Diablo Rojo.
Take more than my share, erase hell. Come on, shake it, make it break it.
You motherfuckers are fucking awesome, man. I definitely wanted to be able to grow up and do what I wanted to be able to do and still be able to make a living. And the Lord has blessed me as such by sending you crazy motherfuckers to me. And I just want to tell y'all, man, from the bottom of my motherfucking big, I got a big fucking heart. Big fucking heart. And from the bottom of that ugly motherfucking big heart, I want to tell each and every one of y'all, thank you so very much for putting food on my table and a roof over my head. On behalf of myself and these four badass motherfuckers up here behind me, my hat's off to you, Dayton. And if you don't mind, I'd like to just tell y'all the same way I tell my friends and family back at home in Texas. Get the fuck off my property. Appreciate the fuck out you, Ohio. God bless you crazy motherfuckers, man. I'm telling you right now, man, you guys are definitely allowing myself and these four men up here behind me to live the fucking dream. Thank each and every one of you so very much. I have to truly say, and I am being honest as a motherfucker, I am thoroughly enjoying the hell out y'all's coming this evening, baby! Now, these fellas up here behind me, they're highly professional. I'm just kind of highly. Not so much professional. So this next song here, they're going to kick its fucking ass. And I'm going to fuck it up. But don't say shit. As a matter of fact, when I get done, you just tell me how fucking good of a job I fucking did. It made me feel better about myself. Appreciate the fuck out y'all, man. We're gonna take you all the way back to the first album of Carved Records. This one here is called Cocked and Loaded. You will. Y'all, man. When I was a young kid, you know, classes of people, they didn't mingle like they do today. I'm looking out here tonight. I see a lot of people out here hanging around tonight with each other. And I know that if we was all in the pen, we would all be in different places of the yard, most likely. But tonight, we are fucking all standing together under one fucking flag, baby. It makes me feel good inside to be able to bring all these different kinds of people from all walks of life together. Makes me feel real fucking good inside. Appreciate the fuck out, y'all. Now, when I was a youngin', we didn't ever go into town too very fucking often. But when we did, I noticed that they always talked about the people east of the tracks in town like they was some kind of trash or something. What bothered me is we lived further east than anybody. I always had on a pair of cut-off shorts, bare fucking foot, no fucking shirt. Even at the age of 4, I had hair down to my fucking ass. I was that hell-raising backwood redneck hillbilly motherfucker from the top of that old hill. Yeah. Out there on that hill, there was 3 families. There was the Montgomerys, there was the Nunleys, and there was my clan, the fucking Andersons. Yeah. Funny thing about it is, we called that hill Paw Paw Hill. It had a different name whenever we would talk about it. We called it Paw Paw Hill. Everybody else called it Eisenhower Hill. Well, you know, maybe some good old redneck hillbilly backwood motherfuckers can change a fucking name on a sign. What you know about that, folks? Because now these days, when you go out east of Maine and you go across them railroad tracks and you head up that hill, there's a big old sign that says, "Welcome to Paw Paw Hill." We'll be right back. I want to thank all you badass motherfuckers for making it worth the trip from fucking Texas. Y'all some badass motherfuckers. Now, I'm gonna tell you something. Next time I come here,
we're coming to see you.
If I don't see these same fucking faces, that's right. That's right. You think I'm taking those pictures for fucking fun, huh? I'm taking them pictures, so I got a list of motherfuckers whose asses I gotta whoop if they don't show up at my next fucking show and take fucking Ohio. I know what some of you are thinking. He don't know where I live. I know where fucking Walmart is. I know even though you fucking hate Walmart, you still gotta go there once a fucking month for some fucking reason. I'll sit outside of Walmart and stop a mud hole in the Walmart fucking parking lot. And I see that some of you are pretty big old boys and you're thinking, hell, he can't whoop me. I want you to know something, boy. I ain't afraid to take no fucking ass whooping. I'll tell you right now, I'll take a black eye, you get a black eye. If you're too big, I get a black eye, you get a stomp fucking toe. I'll bite your pinky toe off. I don't give a fuck. One thing you don't want to do, folks, you do not want to see me pissed off! And mad the fuck up about it! We'll be right back.
Something we do, stole it from Motley fucking Crue.